In today's video, we're going to create a nice and simple seamless title animation inside of Adobe After Effects by using some motion graphics technique. This video is going to be super fun and super easy, a step-by-step tutorial even for absolute beginners. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's open After Effects and get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is going to be the main composition. So let's call it main. Set the size of this composition maybe 1920 in width, 1080 in height, frame rate 60, duration make it 3 seconds long, background color black, hit OK. Now we have to create our background. So just go to the layer, go to new and take a new solid layer, and this is going to be the color. So let's call it color. Select a dark red color, maybe maroon color, just like that, hit OK. You can select any color that you like. After that, we have to create a texture on it. So we need a texture file. So just go to the project window. Just right click on this project window, go to import file and select a texture file. So in this case, I'm using this texture file, which is old painted metallic. I have downloaded this texture from pixabay.com, and I will give you a link in the description. So you can just go to the link in the description and download the texture, or you can use any different texture that you like and click on import. Now we have to create a separate composition for the texture. So just go to the composition, take a new composition, and this is going to be the texture. So let's call it texture. Leave the setting as it is, hit OK. Now you can drag and drop the texture file inside of the texture composition, and then you can fit the texture according to you. Just like that. And then go to your main composition, and here we have to import the texture inside of the main composition, just like that. Now we have to blend the texture with the background color. So click on the toggle switches, and here we have the blending mode. So just go to the blending mode of the texture and select the overlay. Now it's looking like this. Alright, and after that we have to create our text over here. So select the text tool, go to the character. If you don't have the character, then go to window and check this option character, and select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using this Gotham Ultra font style. You can select any different font style that you like. Set the size of the text maybe 1100 pixel. You can set the character spacing 0, line spacing auto. Click here and type any single letter. So I'm going to type 5. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all. And let's select the pure white color. Hit OK. After that, we have to align it to the center. But before that, just go to the paragraph, and here click on the center text, and then go to the align and click on the align horizontally, click on the align vertically. After that, we have to set the anchor point in the center of the text. So select the move tool first, select the text layer, hold control on the keyboard and just double click on this span behind tool, and now the anchor point is in center. After that, we have to blend the text with the background. So select the move tool, just go to the blending mode and set it to soft light. After that, we have to create edges around the text. So select the text, hit Ctrl D to duplicate. Right click on the second text, call it edges. You can set the blending mode to normal for the upper text. And then we have to create the stroke effect. So select the text layer, go to character, and here we have to turn off the fill color and turn on the stroke color. Click on the no fill color button and make it like this. You have to select a color from here. So you can select the stroke color, maybe red. You can select any color according to your theme. And then we have to set the thickness of the stroke. So let's set the thickness of the stroke maybe 6 pixels, which is absolutely perfect. And then we have to down the opacity of the stroke. So select the edges layer, hit T on the keyboard to open the opacity. And here you can set the opacity maybe 25%, and we will get something like this. After that, we have to create animated glitch kind of effect. So select the edges, hit Ctrl D to duplicate. Right click on that, click on rename, and you can call it glitch. Hit T on the keyboard and set the opacity maybe 100%. After that, we have to create noise layer. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. Let's call it noise. I'm going to apply fractal noise effect on the noise layer. So just go to the effect and preset and search for fractal noise. So this is the fractal noise effect. Let's drag and drop on the solid layer. And here we have to do some settings. So just go to the fractal type and set it to dynamic. Go to the noise type and set it to block. And here we have the contrast and the brightness. For the contrast, I'm going to set it to 100, brightness minus 50. And here we have the complexity. Let's set the complexity 3. Open the transform and here we have the scale. Let's increase the scale value and set the value maybe 600. Perfect. And then we have to animate the evaluation. I'm going to use the time expression for the evaluation. So hold Alt on the keyboard and click on this stopwatch button to open the expression box. Let's type time expression over here. So I'm going to type time multiply by 250. Perfect. And then we will get something like this. And after that, I'm going to make the black section transparent. So what we have to do, just select the noise. Go to the effect and preset and search for Luma key. Let's apply the Luma key on the noise layer. And here we have the threshold. Let's set the value maybe 15. And finally, we have something like this. After that, we have to colorize this noise. So just go to effect and preset again and search for hue and saturation. So this is the hue and saturation effect. Let's drag and drop on the noise layer. And here, check this option, colorize. Let's increase the value of colorize saturation, maybe 100. And you can change the colorize hue. So let's pick your favorite color, maybe like this. And after that, I'm going to use this noise as a matte. So select the glitch text and drag and drop over on this noise layer. Select the noise and go to the track matte option and change this track matte to glitch. After that, select the noise and the glitch, right click on that, click on pre-compose and let's call it glow. Check this option, move all attributes into the new composition, hit OK. And then we have to apply the glow effect on it. So just go to effect and preset and search for glow. Let's drag and drop the glow effect on the glow layer. And here we have to increase the glow radius. Let's set the value maybe 25%. And finally, we will get this type of glitchy effect, which is looking absolutely nice. And then select the color and the texture, right click on that, click on pre-compose and make it a single layer. So let's call it background. Check this option and hit OK. Now we have to create a main text over here. So for the main text, select the text tool, just go to the character and here we have to reduce the size of the text. So I'm going to set the value maybe 400 pixel. Let's decrease the character spacing and set the value maybe negative 120 and click over here, type anything, whatever you want, just like that. After that, hit Ctrl A to highlight all. And you have to turn off the stroke and turn on the fill color. So again, you can click on the no stroke color and you will get something like this. Now we have to align it to the center. So select the move tool, go to align, click on the align horizontally, click on the align vertically, set the anchor point in the center, select the text, hold Ctrl on the keyboard and just double click on the span behind tool. Now the anchor point is in center. After that, we have to apply the overlapping effect on it. So just open the text. Here we have the animate. Click on the animate button. Enable pre-character 3D. Click on the animate again. And here we have the rotation. And we have to change the value of the Y rotation. So I'm going to set the value of Y rotation maybe negative 6 degree. Perfect. And then we have to create a copy of this text layer. So hit Ctrl D to duplicate. Select the bottom text layer, open it up, go to animate again. And here we have the blur. Click on the blur effect and we have to increase the blur value. So I'm going to set the value maybe 125%. Perfect. And then you can close the layer, select the bottom layer and go to the character. And here we have to select a different color. Something like this. And now select both the text layer, right click on that, click on pre-compose, and this is going to be the main title, so let's call it title. Check this option and hit OK. Now we have to animate the whole scene. So what we have to do, we have to create a null object. So just go to the layer, go to new and take a new null object. And this null object is going to be the controllers. Right click on the null object, click on rename, call it controller. Perfect. Now we have to turn on the 3D button for all the layers. So click on the toggle switch edge and turn on the 3D button for all the layers. Just leave the background only and then select all the layers, hit P on the keyboard to open the position property and create a position gap between each layers in GS space. So just leave the background and select the first text layer. Set the value maybe -800. Select the second text layer and set the same value -800. Select the glow and for this one, let's set the value maybe 1500 or 1600, -1600 maybe, and select the main title and set the value -2200. Perfect. And then we have to fit the scale of each layers. So select all the layers, hit S to open this scale property. Now just select the title first. Let's decrease the scale value and set it like this. And do the same thing for all. Select all the layers, hit U to close all the layers. And now we have to parent all the layers with the controller. So select all the layers and leave the controller and the background only. Pick the pick whip and attach with this controller. Select the controller and now let's animate the controller parameter. So just go to one second over here, hit P on the keyboard to open this position property. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on position property. Go to very first frame of this animation and let's set the position value something like this. Set the value maybe -2000. Alright, and then go to the end of this animation maybe on 3 seconds and let's change the value and set this value maybe 20 or maybe 75. And finally, we will get something like this. Perfect. Now select all the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight this point, hold this handle and just drag it on the left side. Highlight this point again, hold this handle and drag it on the right side. Hold this handle as well and drag it on the right side. Close this graph editor and finally, we will get something like this. Alright, now just go to one second and here we have to hit R on the keyboard to open this rotation property. And here we have this Z rotation. So turn on the stopwatch button and lock the Z rotation value as it is at 1 second. Go to very first frame and here let's set the Z rotation value -30°. Now select all the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, highlight this point and drag it on the left side. And finally, we will get this type of animation, which is looking absolutely perfect. Now let me show you one more thing. Just go to the layer, go to new and take a new adjustment layer. And this is going to be the color controller. So let's call it color, hit enter. Just go to effect and preset and search for hue. Let's drag and drop the hue and saturation effect on the color controller. And here you can change the color. You can select any color that you like. Alright, so just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome and that is it for now. I hope you like this video. If you have any question, drop a message on my Instagram or comment down below. If you are watching this video first time on this channel, please hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.